Welcome everyone. I am Professor D.V. Thorat from Department of Agronomy. Today we are going to see the production technology of jute or the cultivation practices of jute crop. In that first one, we are going to see the introduction. Jute is, as we know, jute is a kharif crop and it is normally known as a vegetable fiber crop, which is most important crop after the cotton, which is used for the preparation of rope, twine, carpet, rugs, hazel cloths and much more. And it is also considered as the cheapest and strongest source of all natural, among the all natural fibers. And it is also considered as a fiber for the future. It is most eco-friendly fiber and also known as a golden fiber. The cotton crop or cotton fiber is known as a white gold, and the jute is known as a golden fiber. In that, for the cultivation of jute, in case of production of natural jute and the raw jute fiber, for the quality and quantity, Bangladesh is the biggest producer. This is the picture of golden fiber. In case of origin and distribution, for the white jute, that is Corchorus capsularis, is the originator from Indo-Burma or including South China. And the Tosa jute, that is Corchorus olitorius, is originated from the Africa. According to Kundu, Kundu is a scientist, and in 1951, he stated that the primary center of origin of Corchorus olitorius, means Tosa jute, is Africa, and the secondary center is India or Indo-Burma region. In India, it is spread from Egypt or Afghanistan, and from there it was spread in China and Philippines. Next one is white jute. The history. White jute means Corchorus capsularis. During the Mughal Empire of Akbar, the poor villagers of India normally used the clothes which are made up of jute. Simple hand looms and hand spinning wheels were used by the weavers, who used to spin the cotton yarn as well. And also the history states that the jute is mostly used in Bengal for the preparation of rope and twines, and also for the preparation of different household items and other uses. The history of Tosa jute, that is Corchorus olitorius, it states that it is a Afro-Arabian variety, and which is popular for its leaves, which is most important ingredient in a Musilla genus pot herb, which is also called as a Molokhia, and popular in Arab countries. The book of Job in a Herbew Bible mentions this vegetable, pot herb, as a Jew's mallow. Next one is scientific classification, scientific name or classification. Its local name is Tosapat or Sadapat, and the English name is jute. The scientific name of Tosa jute is Corchorus olitorius, and for the white jute, it is Corchorus capsularis, and the family is Tiliaceae. In case of botanical description of jute, the plant is annual herb, tall, slender, and half shrubby, and the height is about 2 to 3 meters, and the stem of that plant is long, slender, and color varies from blue green to dark red in case of capsularis, and green capsularis means white jute, and in case of olitorius, it is green or colored light red or deep red and terminally branched. In case of root, in both jute, the white jute and Tosa jute, the roots are well branched and taproot system, and having a taproot system. The leaves are simple and petiolate, and the flower is small and yellow in color. The white jute and Tosa jute are distinguished by the fruit size or fruit shape. The fruit, the capsule in case of capsularis, Corchorus capsularis, that is white jute, is round, and in Corcorus olitorius, it is elongated. These are the picture. The first picture is of white jute and the second picture is Tosa jute. The varieties of jute. For the white jute, varieties are as follows. That is Kakia Bombay R85, D154, D386, Fandu, C212, C13, C321, C412, C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, CVE3, CVL1, CC45, BJC83, BJC7370 and C38. And for the Tosa jute, it is R26, R27, CG, O2, O3, O4, O5, O9897, OM1 and O72. There are different crop rotation, profitable crop rotation system which are normally recommended in case of jute and along with in case of jute. Firstly, we are going to see what is crop rotation. Crop rotation means cultivation of one crop after harvesting of previous crop. That is called as a crop rotation during the 1 year over the same land. Over the same land, it is called as a crop rotation, which is help for the increasing the income of the farmer and also restoration of nutrient and the fertility of land is maintained. In case of jute, we can adopt crop rotation or we can carry out crop rotation with the crops, for example, rice, wheat, then mung bean, gram, then tobacco, potato, radish, lentils, spinach and pumpkin, onion, and mustard. These are the examples of crop rotation which are very profitable to increase the income of any farmer. Next is climate. The suitable climate for growing jute is offered by the monsoon climate during the monsoon season. And the temperature requirement is 20 to 40 degrees Celsius and the humidity is 70 to 80%, which is favorable for the successful cultivation or successful growth of that plant. In case of soil and land type, it required plain alluvial soil and standing water. Alluvial sandy loam, clay loam soils are the best suited for the production of jute crop. In case of white jute, that is capsularis, Corcorus capsularis, which can be grown in a standing water, especially latter part of its growth. And in case of Tosa jute, that is olitorius, will not thrive under the standing water, means it is a resistant to drought condition. And it can be grow over the lighter soil. The pH requirement for the both jute, that is white jute and Tosa jute, is 6.5 to 7.5. Next is rainfall. For the cultivation of jute crop, about 5 to 8 cm of rainfall is required during the growth period of that crop from sowing to harvesting. Next one is planting time. For the planting time, in case of white jute, we can plant white jute in the month of March to April. And in case of Tosa jute, we can plant or cultivate that crop or sowing can be carried out at early March. Next one is seed rate. The sowing of jute crop is done by either broadcasting or line sowing. In case of Tosa jute, the seed rate for line sowing is 5 kg per hectare and for the broadcasting it is 7 kg per hectare and the spacing is 25 by 5 cm and the number of plants per square meter is 80. And in case of white jute, the seed rate for the line sowing is 7 kg per hectare and for the broadcasting it is 10 kg per hectare and the spacing is 30 by 5 cm and the plant population per square meter is 67. Next is intercultural operations. What is intercultural operations? Means the operations which are going to carried out in a standing crop, that is called as a intercultural operation. As we know, the weed management or hand weeding is most important intercultural operation in any crop to increase the production of that crop or to avoid the weed crop competition. So we can carry out hand weeding during the early growth period or during the crop during the critical growth period of that crop for the crop weed competition. And for the jute crop, it is about 20 to 40 days after sowing are considered as a critical growth period for the crop and weed competition. And if we are going to follow the cultural practices to control the weed population, that time two hand weedings are done. First hand weeding is done at 20 to 25 days after sowing, and second hand weeding is done after 35 to 40 days of sowing. And if we are going to carry out chemical control, that time we have to spread fluchloralin, that is pre-emergence herbicide, which is applied after 3 days of sowing, and the rate of application is 1.5 kg per hectare, which is 5 days after sowing. Means when we are going to carry out cultural practices, then we have to do 2 hand weeding. And if you are going to carry out integrated weed management, that is that means combination of cultural and chemical practices, that time we have to carry out a spraying of pre-emergence herbicide, and after that one hand weeding. Next one is water management. For jute crop, the water requirement of that crop is 500 mm during the whole growth period of that crop, and the first irrigation is given after first irrigation is given at the time of sowing, and the second irrigation is given at 4 days after sowing. Afterward we have to give irrigation at the irrigation interval of 15 days. Then next one is drainage. Appropriate drainage facility may be arranged in order to avoid the stagnation of water in the event of high rainfall during the crop growth period. As we know, the white jute cannot be thrive under under the standing water, but the tosa jute cannot be thrive under the standing water. Then to avoid the disadvantages of standing water, we have to carry out the drainage facility to run out the excess water from the field in a high rainfall area. Next one is nutrient and fertilizer management. In case of FYM, we have to apply 5 to 10 tons of FYM per hectare. And for the Tosa jute, the requirement of NPK in case of rain fed is 30:15:15 kg per hectare, and in case of irrigated condition it is 80:40:40 kg per hectare. And in case of white jute rain for the rain fed situation, it is 40:20:20 kg per hectare NPK, and for the irrigated situation it is 80:40:40 kg per hectare NPK. We have to apply the P and K dose at the time of sowing, and if the we are going to cultivate the jute crop in a heavy soil, that time the whole dose of nitrogen is given. But when we are going to sow that jute crop in a lighter soil, that time we have to give nitrogen in a 2 split doses. First dose of nitrogen is given at the time of sowing, and second dose of nitrogen is given at 4 to 5 weeks of after the 4 to 5 weeks of sowing. Next is a pest. There are different pest incidents over the jute crop, in that jute hairy caterpillar, semi looper, stem weevil, field cricket and yellow mite. And the disease is leaf spot, leaf rot, root rot, anthracnose, leaf blight, white spongy rot, saprophyte, steam rot, wilt and dry rot, and last one is mosaic. Harvesting. Jute crop is harvest is mature between 120 to 150 days. Means the period required for the completion of growth and development of that crop is about 150 days. And when the flowers of jute crop is completely dry off, that time the healthy fiber is good healthy fiber is harvested. And the height is kept during the harvesting is 8 to 12 feet from the ground, which are cutted near the stems are cutted from the stems are cutted near the ground level. And in case of flooded plant, the plants are allowed to uprooted. The harvesting plants are kept in a field for 3 to 4 days for drying of that crop or shedding of that leaves. And the stems of and the bundles of that stem is allowed to prepare or made up. And after that, the stipping process is carried out. Yield. For the green plant, the yield is the weight of yield is 45 to 50 tons per hectare. And in case of fiber yield, it is 2 to 25 tons per hectare. Next one is fiber extraction process. In fiber extraction process, what is fiber extraction process? Separation of fiber from the stem of jute is called as a fiber extraction process. In that, rating is carried out and after that extraction is done. These two images are the images of rating process. Rating means nothing but it is a microbial process which allow to separation of fiber from the stem or woody stalk of that jute crop, which is microbial process and which is done either aerobic or anaerobic microflora. In rating process, the bundles of stems are made up and they allow to kept in a slowly running canal water. And these bundles are kept at the depth 30 to 60 centimeter. And to avoid the floating of that stem bundles, the weight is putting over that bundles, and the weight is of concrete blocks or stones. And after that, it kept under the observation for the 8 days. And after 8 days, the rating process will completed, and these bundles are allowed for the fiber extraction. If we are going to put that bundles for more than 8 days, then that time it gives poor quality of fiber. That fiber is known as a dazed fiber. Then 8 days, hence the 8 days is sufficient for the completion of rating process of that jute crop. What is rating process? Nothing but the separation of fiber from the stalk of, from the woody stalk of that crop is called as a rating. For the rating, clear, deep and soft water is required, which is ideal for that process. And the temperature requirement is about 34 degrees Celsius. Next one is extraction. Extraction is nothing but the fiber is extracted separately from each reed with the help of finger. First one is image of extraction with the help of finger, which gives the clean fiber and being stalked with. And the second one is an image in which the stalking of that stalking of stems is carried out. When we are going to compare the fiber extract, these two fiber extraction process, the first one is stipping out the first one is separation of that fiber from the stalk of that plant, and second one is beating of that fiber. The first process, that is separation of fiber with the help of fingers from woody stock gives clean fiber, and the second image, that is beating of stem of jute, gives the fiber which is not that much clean when we are going to compare with the first process. And after separation of that fiber from the stem of jute crop, these fibers are allowed to washing, and after washing, the drying of fiber is done for 2 to 3 days, and after drying of fiber, they are allowed for the transportation of jute. This is the most important process which may be going to ask in your exam for the theory paper. Next one is uses. As we saw in earlier slide, that jute crop is useful for the preparation of ropes, sacks, bag, blanket, yarn, rugs, hazel cords, wall mats. Then CBC yarn, jutex yarn by blending with a cordon fiber. Nowadays, green jute is used to produce the paper. It is also used for the preparation of boards, then also used for the cooking. The leaves or shoot of jute is used for cooking. These are the images of the product which are prepared from the jute crop. Thank you. If you have any questions regarding this, you can leave your comment in a comment box. Thank you so much.